The Apple's Reminders app is truly one of the best implemented reminders and to-do app in my opinion. It is super powerful, feature-rich, amazing integration if you are in Apple ecosystem, and if you know how to use it properly, it'll definitely be the most used app on your phone, like how it is for me. In this video, I'll show you how to use the Reminders app, the UI, how to add tasks in multiple different ways, how to organize them, how to better search task list, and so much more useful information. So let's get started. Let's get something clear first. The Reminders app can store both a reminder and a to-do task. What does that mean? A reminder is a to-do task which is time sensitive. For example, pick up cake from the bakery at 5 p.m. Here, you want to be reminded about your task. If there is no time associated, for example, pay car loan, it's just a to-do item with no need to be reminded at a particular time. The Reminder app will do both. Okay, this is the icon for the iOS Reminders app. If it's not on your home screen, search for it like this. As soon as you open the app, you are greeted with the main page. There is so much more going on here, so let me explain the UI first. Let's go from the bottom. This button here called the New Reminder is what you can use to create a new reminder. Once you tap on it, you can give it a title and add more notes if you want. I will get to the other icons in this page shortly. Did you notice that I did not add any time to it? It's simply a to-do list. Hit add to create your first task. So simple, right? This will add the reminder to your default list. But what is a list? List is nothing but a list of reminders you can group for better organization. You can create a list by tapping at the bottom right. Here, you can give the list a name. I am going to give it Black Friday shopping list. I can choose any of the icons below. If I don't like any of these inbuilt icons, I can even pick a smiley like this. I'm gonna pick the shopping cart smiley. I can also pick a color theme for this list. Hit done and the list is created. I can now go into the shopping list we just created and start adding things I plan to buy for this Black Friday. Like this, you can create multiple lists for your different needs. I have one for Amazon buys, one for my favorite restaurants, one for my monthly finance related tasks, one for my YouTube video work, and many more. And those lists are all shown here. Let's see what else we got on this main page. Above the lists, this section is called the pinned section. There are some pre-pinned lists, but if there are so many lists on your phone and you want something to be on top, you can long press that list and tap pin. Now that list is pinned at the top and it's ready for you to access quickly. At the top of the page, there is a search bar for you to search for any of your tasks in any of the lists. Okay. Now we know how the user interface is organized in the Reminders app. Let's get into three main categories about reminders. One, how to create and manage tasks and reminders. Second, how to organize reminders. And third, how to search and retrieve reminders. Let's start with creating reminders. What we saw was just scratching the surface. Let's get into the details. I'll go into my shopping list. I want to add a reminder to buy a new SD card for me. My title goes Buy New SD Card. Under notes, I'm gonna put SanDisk Extreme, which is what I want. Now, the next section here is to tell when the Reminders app should remind or notify you. Is it based on date or time, or is it based on location or when texting someone? If I want to be reminded about it at a certain time, I can add a date and a time like this to be notified about it at that time. I don't need a notification, so I'm gonna disable them. Next, tags. These are highly useful for searching and organizing. I will talk more about it in the next section, but for now, know that it works much more like Instagram hashtags. Since this is an Amazon buy, I'm gonna tag it as hashtag Amazon buy. There is also an option to be reminded based on location, for example, when you arrive at a store or when you get into your car, etc. Another awesome reminder feature for me is to be reminded when texting a person. If you enable this option and select a person, when you text that person, reminders will notify you about the reminder. For example, wishing happy birthday when texting the person next time. All your birthday reminders can go into a separate list. The next section helps you add more details to your reminder, like you can flag it, set the priority for the reminder, choose the list where you want this reminder to go, and even add an image for future reference. This was very detailed entry. There are easier ways to create reminders as well. First, you can tap here at an empty empty spot to create a simple reminder. This is a fast way to quickly add many items on the list. When you tap to add a reminder, you also get the shortcut icons at the bottom, which gives you the same functionality like adding a date, time, location, hashtag, flagging, and adding an image to the task. Here, I'm adding a task with a date to be reminded and also a hashtag. These are some easy ways to add details to the task. The Reminders app also understands natural language. So instead of going through all that details hoop, you can add details in natural language like this. Buy Sony lens at 5 PM tomorrow. The app understands it and suggests the date and time. All these still seem complicated. Siri can make things even more easier. To add a reminder, simply invoke Siri and say, remind me to pick up dry cleaning at 5 PM tomorrow. So simple. Here, a reminder got added to my default list. If you want to simply add a task to a particular list, you can add that too with Siri like this. Add fruits to my shopping list. There you go, an item was added to the list of choice. These are all some common and easy ways of adding reminders and tasks to my to-do list. But my favorite reminder features of all got to be the sharing feature from Safari. I do a lot of online window shopping, and anytime I like something, I simply tap and share and select reminders and add them to my window shopping list. This way, a new entry is created in my Reminders app with a link to the website for my future reference. This is awesome. I have many Safari specific lists that I share to Reminders app frequently, like reading later list, Pinterest inspiration list, clothing shopping list, and many more. It's like bookmarking, but into multiple lists and way easier for me to search and organize later. This trick even works in mail apps too when you select something and share to Reminders. Okay, creating a reminder or task was easy. How to delete them or mark them complete? I think it's pretty intuitive, right? Just tap on the circle at the side and it just disappears. You can see the list of completed items here too if needed. If you want to delete the whole list, you can do that too by swiping on a list to its left. Okay, that was different ways of creating reminders, list, adding details, and marking them complete. But the real power of Reminders app lies in how well you can organize those reminders and tasks and how can you search them. In this part, we will see how to better organize your reminders and lists. This is what will take your reminders to a pro level and make this app really productive. First, we already saw how we can create individual lists and organize multiple tasks and items within them. But there is more. Within a list, you can create subsections. For example, this is a list of my favorite restaurants. Here, I like it to be sectioned based on cuisines. Now, I can tap on three dots here and create a section. I'll name this as Indian. I can now drag and drop Indian cuisine restaurants to this section easily. Or I can even add new entry into this section directly too. This way, I can create more sections for each cuisine separately and organize my items within the list. This has been so useful in many of my lists. Another feature within these sections, you can view these sections as vertical columns. Tap the three dots again and tap view as column. This gives a much nicer view to my organized sections. They look so organized and very easy to add or remove items from each section. This is for adding your custom sections, but Apple Reminders can do this automatically for your shopping using Smart List. When you create a new list, if it's a grocery shopping list, you can change the type of list here as grocery list. Doesn't seem like much happened, right? But when you start adding items to this list, for example, milk, vegetables, paper towels, the app automatically organizes and categorizes them into sections for you. Any new entries are also categorized immediately. Now, when you go to the grocery store, the items are automatically organized as per sections and you do not need to go back and forth between items. I simply love this feature. You know, this auto-categorization is not just for groceries. You can create your own custom smart lists as per your needs. Check this out. I'm simply adding a generic reminder. This is a new restaurant I wish to go, so I hashtag it as restaurant. I'm also adding another reminder item generically. This item is grocery item I want to buy, so I hashtag it as grocery. Next, I add another Amazon buy item. Notice that I added them generically and not in a list. But see here that these reminders automatically went into their respective lists. This is even more useful when I add items using widgets. To do this, you need to create a smart list. When you create a new list, tap the list type and select smart list. Now, tap on edit filters and select what reminders needs to go into list based on what conditions. Here I'm selecting that any reminder with hashtag as restaurant needs to go into this list. You can pick other filters if you want. That's it. The reminders app will automatically group all the reminders based on your filter into this smart list. Easy organization. This will work even after you create a list and when you add new items that match the filter. One of my most used features within the reminders app is that I can share my list to anyone so easily. We can do this either by long pressing a list and tapping on share list or by going into a list and tapping here to share the list with someone. My husband and I have multiple shared lists where we both add items simultaneously. Shopping list, places to go list, and a lot more lists. We have shared amongst us rather than each of us maintaining a separate list and sharing it later. There are two more must-know organizing features within the reminders app. First is you can create a reminder or to-do item within another to-do item. Let me show you. When I create a reminder, I can swipe it to the right to indent the item to be a subtask within the above item. I use it mostly like when I have a YouTube video task, I create subtasks within them like scripting, filming, editing, thumbnails, etc. These are all within my YouTube subtask and I can manage each subtask or entire task as a whole. The second one is I like indenting and creating subtasks. You can indent and create sublists as well. In the list of lists on the main UI, just drag and drop a list on top of another list you want to group together. Now give the group a new name and now you have like a group or a folder containing your other lists. There are so many ways to organize and make the best use of Reminders app. Reminders app has one of the best organizational features of any to-do apps available today. Okay, we saw different ways of adding reminders and lists, way to organize them, tag them, share them, and group them. The third category and an important one is to understand how to find, search, and retrieve them easily. Reminders app also gives us a ton of ways to do this. Obviously, the most intuitive way to search for an item in the search bar above. Simple, right? But we also have the option to search for a bunch of tasks using hashtags that you added before. Search for any hashtag directly on the search bar and the app will list all the items tagged within that hashtag. Not just that, if you scroll all the way to the bottom in the main page, you can see a list of all the hashtags you have added so far. Just tap on any hashtag and immediately all the reminders and tasks associated with that hashtag will be filtered and shown to you, even if these tasks are across different lists. You can even pick multiple hashtags to filter or even show only the items that do not contain that tag. I sometimes tag my restaurants based on cuisine, location, restaurant type, and then use hashtag to filter it based on my mood, like restaurant in Seattle, Indian cuisines, vegetarian only, etc. Try it out. It's so handy in so many ways. If you use any one particular list more frequently, you can long press it and pin it to the top of the page for easy access. You can also edit this section according to your needs or add smart lists will do even more filtering and bring it to the top of the pin section. That was already a lot of information. There are so many more pro level features within the reminders app, which I will make it as a separate video. Hope the information shared about the reminders app in this video were useful to you. If so, a like and subscribe would be amazing as well. I'll see you all in the next video. Until then, this is Anjana. Bye bye.